तो पुनीत प्लीज टेक दिस सर्टिफिकेट, यू सक्सेसफुली कंप्लीटेड भक्त हिज ग्रेस सर्वेश्वर श्याम सुंदर हिज ग्रेस करुणा सिंधु. हरे कृष्ण. सो अदर स्टूडेंट्स बिकॉज ऑफ फीस्ट दे आर ऑब्सेंट आफ्टर ईटिंग हेवी फीस्ट. So 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, 12. Huh? Only online bara 12. Okay. So we were discussing in the last class about the dharma, dharma artha kama, so the relation between these three, and also bhakti. So according to Sudha Goswami, so what is the meaning of dharma? So dharma means it's meant for what? Dharma is meant for satisfaction of, one should do the dharma for the satisfaction of Hari, and it should bring bhakti. Dharma means any occupational duty, varna and ash dharma, that has to bring bhakti in Krishna. What is that bhakti? It is Vasudeva Katharachi. It should bring. So in dharmasya hyapavargasya. So yesterday I was writing apavargasya, but not just apavargasya, apavargasya. Yeah, is there tadit pratyekam, and then apavargya, apavargasya. So dharma means what there in this sloka? Dharma means here what we understood, that is the apavargaha. That means what it mean, apavargaha means which brings bhakti, bhakti sampadakaha dharmaha apavargaha. So apavargaha means bhakti sampadakaha, that means which brings bhakti. But any dharma if you do and someone is very strict follower of dharma, what is that? Dharma is, what is that? Internet is not correct, is not continuous. Problem. See? It's stuck. Hare Krishna. Your network bandwidth is low. Why? They took optical. Purana hai, acha. 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 They are hearing, so okay, fine. But video is stuck. Okay, no problem. So if you are not able to hear me, so please let me know. So next, apavargyaha means bhakti sampadakaha, that we learn. But if you do dharma, So dharma's follower, who is that? It is artha. So any dharma if you do, artha will come. So that artha is not meant for getting the sense objects, but what is the use of that artha? That artha should be used to get the objects of senses by which we can maintain our body and soul together. So that kind of, yeah, that kind of things, is said. Then after that, that artha, then we maintain our life. So what is the need of the life? Why one should maintain body and soul together? The purpose is tattva jignasa. That means what? One side we are saying dharma is meant for the getting the bhakti, you are saying. That means dharma means bhakti sampadaka, you are saying. And now you are saying, you are ending up with the tattva jignasa. What is this? So what is the difference between these two? So here you are saying dharma should be done for the bhakti. But somehow artha is coming, from that artha we are getting the objects to maintain life, and we maintain life, and that maintaining life is meant for the tattva jignasa. Then what? These two are going into two different directions. How to connect these two? How to connect? Arjuna Sakaparu, how to connect these two?
Karma is tattva jikyasa, by tattva jikyasa we know the sambandha tatya, and by knowing the sambandha tatya we can do the practice the bhakti or the parat, and we can practice the paratattva sanmukhya after knowing the sambandha tatya.
Anyone else wants to comment on this? Sachidev Prabhu, yes.
Yeah, Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Yeah. You said that maintain body and soul together to worship. That is that this is the minimum requirement body of soul, because minimum required body of soul is only required because you have to connect everything to Krishna. That is the answer. That only that much is required so that body and soul is maintained to serve Krishna. Nothing extra is
required. Is that okay? Not okay. Yes, Prabhu. Jai Gopinath, Prabhu.
This Tattva Jigyasa is Paratattva Jigyasa, because the Jiva is conditioned because of not having the knowledge about the paratattva. So this jikyasa, even if you get artha, that has to be used for paratattva jikyasa.
Question, okay.
I was audible, Prabhu.
Yeah, okay, audible, Prabhu.
Yes, yes,
I heard your answer, okay. So what I am asking, we are doing dharma for attaining the bhakti. But Sutta Goswami's explanation, if you see, dharma is meant for the bhakti, okay. But by doing that dharma, you are getting the some kind of artha, and that artha is used to get the minimum bare necessities of the life to maintain body and soul together. So by that maintenance of, so that maintain the life, to do the tattva jignasa, then why he is saying, in here also he should say that maintaining body and soul together is also meant for the bhakti. Yes or no? Dharma, he said, dharmasya hyapavargasya, dharma is meant for the bhakti. There he said, Then after that, so Naartho Yascheha Karma Bihi. So that means Kamasya Nindriya Preeti Labo Jive Tayavata. Jivasya Tattva Jignasa. Why he said? He could have said Jivasya Bhakti. Bhakti Jignasa, no? Bhakti Karaniyam, something. He should say like this or not? Why he is saying? Because dharma is meant for the bhakti, then maintaining the life also should be meant for bhakti. Yes or no? That means Sota Goswami is confusing us. Yes? No? Why? What do you want to say answer? Yes. Why? How he is not confusing? I want to hear.
We already discussed in Tattva Sandarbha. That Tattva ultimate is the Advaim Gyanam, Sukrupam, then Krishna. We have reached there. So this Tattva Jagyasa ultimately directly goes to Krishna. That knowing Krishna and Bhakti, that is similar is there. That connection is there. That's why that is not different. Tattva Jagyasa lead to Bhakti only.
Tattva Jagyasa is
Bhakti.
Are you able to get my question? Yes, yes. Clear? Question is clear. Dharma is meant for bhakti. Then our life is also maintaining body and soul together. That is also should meant for bhakti only or not? Then why he separately saying tattva jignasa? Yes?
Just so in the next step, he can introduce that tattva can be in threefold, and in that way, it can be more broader preaching. So, more kind of people who think that the final goal or too much prasadam. So, it's just to widen the scope of the preaching. So he can introduce in the next step that tattva is a threefold, Brahma, Paramatman, and Bhagavan. And that way it will be just like a twofold.
Okay, I will answer this. Please hear. If anyone want to try, you want to try. Okay. Students are excited. Okay.
Yesterday you mentioned that when Sutta Goswami is saying
yes.
that the purpose of the life is to inquire about absolute truth, is showing that the bhakti's secondary result is the knowledge of tattva.
This is the answer actually. So that means he is saying the life is there to inquire about the tattva. Means what? So it is going to give that life. In that life you have to try for knowing the tattva, which is nothing but the secondary result of the bhakti. That means ultimately, so what he wants to say, tattva jignasa means knowing about the tattvam, getting the knowledge about the tattvam. So that is also possible by what? That dharma which you are doing for the getting the bhakti. So that bhakti, whatever bhakti you are going to get through that dharma, that bhakti secondary result is this tattva, knowing about the tattva. That means this is secondary result. So ultimately, that bhakti, whatever you are going to get, that only will give the knowledge of the tattva also. That means bhakti is the main result of, that means doing that dharma for the pleasure of Hari should be going, will be giving the bhakti, and that bhakti is the main result, and that bhakti's secondary result is a knowledge, that bhakti itself, and that bhakti is going to give anyway tattva gnanam also. That means, so some Devadatta is there. Devadatta, what he is doing? He is doing his prescribed duties. That means maybe take Devadatta is a farmer. So, and he is doing the farming. And he is offering, he is working for the pleasure of the Hari, his prescribed duties. Then what will happen? He will get the Vasudeva Katha Aruchi.
So by following his prescribed duties for the satisfaction of Hari, so then that is going to give the ruchi in the Krishna Katha, then he will be doing this Shravanam Kirtana, holy name, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So one day he will get this. So by this, what is going to happen? So anyway, he is doing the dharma and some artha will be get, and he will be maintaining his body. So by doing this bhakti also, he is going to come to know about tattva. Tattva jnanam also will come automatically by doing, so by that chanting and hearing. That is the meaning actually. Okay, understood? If you are not understanding, it is very good. And if understood, very, very good then. Huh? Okay, later. Okay, then no questions now. Next, so tattva means what? So tattva. Vadanti tat tattva vidas tattvam yajnanam advayam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavan iti shabdyate. So he is not going to do any special endeavor for getting the knowledge of the tattvam. By doing that bhakti itself, he is going to get this, because in the previous sloka he already said. So what is that? Vasudhi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojitaha Janayatyashu Vairagyam Jnanam Cha Yadahaitukam. So that means once if that person is getting the bhakti, that means Katharuchi, after that he will be doing the bhakti. By that bhakti itself, one will get the Jnanam. Jnana, Vairagya. Same point here also is saying. By maintaining the body, he should do the Tattva Jignasa, means he is going to get the knowledge about the Tattvam. So that is happening by what? By that Dharma which you are doing for the Hari's pleasure, Krishna's pleasure. So that is going to give the bhakti, and by that bhakti only you will be getting this also. So next, here Tattvam is said as Advayam Jnanam. By the word Advayam, that means Tattvam is what? Tattvam is one only. Advayam. Advayam. In Tattva Sandarbha, we learned. What is the meaning of Advayam? Anyone remember? The definition of the Advaya Tattvam. Advayam means when you say Advayam, any object is known as Advayam when?
Three criteria, bro. There is one thing that there is no truth superior to that, and there is no equal to that, that truth. And second is that that truth is assisted by its shaktis. And third one is that without him, shaktis cannot work.
Definition of Advayam, who is going to tell? Your answer is not complete. What is the definition of Advayam? Anyone remember? Advayam means, I want exact Sanskrit word. That entity is without a second, Advayam, because there is no other Swataha Siddha Tadrusha Atadrusha Vastvantara Abhavaha. Swataha Siddha Tadrusha Atadrusha Vastvantara Abhavaha. Remember this? Do you remember? Tattva means, Advayam means, there is no other object which is self-accomplished and which is similar to this or
non-similar to this. Understand? There is no other self-accomplished entity similar to or different from it. Swatah siddha tadrusha tadrusha vastvantra bhavaha. Is there, na? You forgot all? What should I do? Tattva Sandarbha students, more than 80% are Tattva Sandarbha students. I don't know. Anuscheda number 4 in the Pramaya Khanda. Open that and you can see. In the Pramaya Khanda. He is searching in Pramana Khanda. Na? Very good. This is... Pramaya Khanda 4. According to our. So tattvam is like this. This take it as a tattvam. Baba. Board. Okay. So there is no other object. There is no other object which is self-accomplished. When can you say this is Advayam Tattvam? There should not be any another object which is self-accomplished and which is similar or dissimilar. These three things should be satisfied to say this is Advayam. No self-accomplished entity which is similar or dissimilar. Okay. Now you take example, this tattvam is who? It is a Krishna. You take it as a Krishna. Now this marker is there. This is the marker. So can it break the advayatvam of this Krishna? Can it break this marker? Can it make this pen? Can it make the... You are saying Krishna is Advaya. And now I am saying this pen is there, one more object. So that's why Krishna is not Advaya. Advaitattvam. Okay. So why? Is it possible? Is it true? Not understanding. 100 kilometers away. Leela Govind Prabhu. You are understanding? The point, I am saying Krishna is Advaya. And to say Krishna is Advaya, there should not be any another object which is self-accomplished and also similar or dissimilar. So now this pen can destroy the Advayatvam of the Krishna? That means, can it become second one and so that you can't say Krishna is not Advayatvam? Can you do like that? Why? Why? Because pen is not self-accomplished. Pen is not self-accomplished. And can say soul. So can it break the Advayatvam of the Krishna? Why? Soul is also not self-accomplished. It is also energy of Krishna only. Can you take Maya? And this Maya is one object. Krishna is one object too.
So that's why you can't say Krishna is Advayam. Can we say like this? Why? Because Maya is also not self-accomplished. So that's why. Everything in this universe, in this, not only in this verse, in the whole creation, all the objects, whatever are there, they are all are the energy of the Krishna. And they are not separate from him. So that's why tattvam is one advayam. So self-accomplished, similar, and also dissimilar. We don't want to have any object which is similar or dissimilar. You're understanding? Krishna, if you want to say Krishna is Advayam Tattvam, so there is no another competitor to him. There should not be another competitor who is self-accomplished, and who, if that competitor is similar to Krishna, then also Krishna is not Advayam. And that competitor is dissimilar to the Krishna, then also Krishna is not Advayam. Because if he is self-accomplished and dissimilar, in that case also Krishna is not Advayam, is not single. There is one more person is there. And also, if you find the any object which is self-accomplished and similar to the Krishna, that is also breaking the, so the Krishna is not Advayam. Okay, so from this, what we are understanding, so since Krishna Adi Paratattvam is Advayam, by saying this, that means what? Whatever you are seeing, anything in this world, this phenomenal world or the spiritual world, any object you are seeing, all the objects, they are not going to become parallel to Krishna. That means they are not going to break the Advayatvam of the Krishna. Means they are all dependent on him and they are all not different from him. So that means this is proving that these are all objects are not different from the Krishna means, then how to connect all these objects with the Krishna? So you can connect all these with the, by considering as Shakti. These are all Shakti or belong to him, Shaktiman, and Shakti and Shaktiman are not different. Shakti Shakti Matoho Bedha Bedau Taucha Achintyo. Like this. So that means here, from the words of Sota Goswami, we should understand that. So Sota Goswami is also following the Achintya Bheda Bheda principle. Yes or no? And also he is showing this everything is energy of the Krishna. And also he is establishing Krishna is a Shaktiman. Krishna is Shaktiman. Yes? No?
So is there any object in this world which is self-accomplished except Krishna?
Self-accomplished?
Except Krishna?
There is no object. They are complete, but they are not self-accomplished. Self-accomplished means it is swataha siddha. Swataha siddha means there is no one is cause for him. No one is cause for him. He cause for himself. So who is that other than Krishna? Is there anyone? No one is there. Everyone is due to the Krishna only. So that means everyone is dependent on Krishna. That means then how to see those things with the Krishna? They are all energy of the Krishna. And you should consider Krishna as Shaktiman. And also, since you are saying now Shakti Shaktiman is there, once again two are coming. So then how to understand this? Oh, this Shakti and Shaktiman, of course they are two, and they are not going to break any kind of the Advayatvam because of the Krishna, because that Shakti is not different from Shaktiman, like this. That's a, if you want to maintain Advayatvam, we should also accept the Abheda. Abheda between the Shakti and Shaktiman. So that's why our philosophy is properly, is justifying the words of Suta Goswami. Okay. So Shakti we established. Then after that, what he is saying? So tad ananyatva vivakshaya tad shaktitvameva angi karoti. Everyone is able to follow the text or not? Line number is Vadandi Tattva Vidas. Open that. So next, Tatra Shakti Varga Lakshana Tad Dharma Tiriktam Kevalam Gnanam Brahmeti Shabdyate Antaryami Maya Maya Shakti Prachurita Shiktyam Chit Shaktyam Shavishishta Paramatma Iti Paripurna Swarna Sarva Shakti Vishishtam Bhagavan. So now, after explaining the Advayam Tattvam in the first sloka, next it is said that, so this Tattvam is also Brahma. Means what? Now you understood this Krishna is nothing but Bhagavan. What? He is having the Shakti. That means he is Shaktiman. I am feeling more convenient on the board instead of this. Okay. I don't know. It's good for my also. Some exercise will have. Otherwise, eating and whole day sitting. Eating and sitting. So here, Shakti Varga Lakshana Tadda Dharma Atiriktam Kevalam Gnanam Brahmeti Shabdyate. So that's why now if you want to understand Brahman, then what is that? Kevala Gnanam. Kevala Gnanam is equal to what? Brahman. Kochidapi Negame Yati Chinmatra Satta. Even in the Mangalacharan we read. And the next, Maya Antaryamitva Maya Maya Shakti Prachura Chit Shakti Vishishtam. That means next what? Antaryami. Antaryami. Antaryamitva Maya. Antaryamitva Maya. Maya Shakti. Antaryamitva Maya Maya Shakti. Prachura. Okay. Maya Shakti plus Kevala Gnanam is what? Paramatma. Next, Paripurna Sarva Shakti. Write the question, give the definitions of Brahma, Paramatma, Bhagavan and Tattvam. Tattvam, Brahma, Paramatma and Bhagavan. Define these four words. Sarva Shakti plus Kevala Gnanam is equal to what? Bhagavan. Write it. What is this? Antaryamitva Maya Maya Shakti Prachura Chishakti means what? Antaryamitva Maya Maya Shakti means That means kevala gnanam, kevala gnanam plus what kind of shakti is there? Antaryamitva shakti. Antaryamitva shakti. That is Paramatma. Is Antaryami. He is having this kind of Antaryamitvamaya shakti. Or otherwise, you can say another word also. Jiva Maya Niyantrutva. Niyantrutva Shakti. Okay. You can say in another way, Jiva Maya Niyantrutva. Shakti plus kevala gnanam is equal to Paramatma. This is also one more definition. You will see in the Paramatma Sandarbha like this also. Okay. Now come to the next page. That means next. Tacha Trida Avirbhava Yuktameva Tattvam Bhaktyaiva Sakshadapi Kriyate. Bhaktya Eva Sakshadapi Kriyate. Ityaha. Okay, done. This tattvam, which is Advaita tattvam, this can be, so you are making photos, huh? PPT. Now that means this Advayam Tattvam, which is nothing but the Bhagavan, that is Krishna, it can be, what Sutta Goswami is saying about this? After saying this sloka, next sloka is 1.2.12. In this 12, he is saying, this tattvam, which is known as Bhagavan, can be, which is also manifesting in three ways, like Brahma, Paramatma, Bhagavan, that can be attained by what? He's saying that can be attained by bhakti. He's saying that can be attained by bhakti. In which sloka? In the next sloka, 1.2.12. See how the flow is going, you should remember from the Savaipumsam to here. Always. And what is this sloka? Tasraddhana muna yognana vairagya yuktaya pashyantyatmani chatmanam bhaktya shrita gruhitaya. So what is the meaning of this? Can anyone read my translation?
The seriously inquisitive student or sage, well equipped with knowledge and detachment, sees the tattva by performing bhakti after hearing from Guru.
Seriously inquisitive student. This is from which? What is the Sanskrit word for this? Tasraddhadhanaha. Or sage. Okay. Well equipped with knowledge and detachment. Means? Jnana vairagya yuktaya. Sees that. Sees. Pashyanti. So what he sees? That. Tattvam by performing bhakti after hearing from Guru. So that means sees that tattvam, which tattvam? That tattvam. By performing bhakti after hearing from Guru. So hearing from Guru, what is the Sanskrit for this? Srita Grihitaya. So by performing bhakti means bhaktya. Okay, something is missing in this. That in the Atmani is missing. In his heart. Atmani means heart. Sees that tattvam in the heart. By performing. In the heart is necessary there. Okay. So now Sota Goswami was saying what he is saying in the 1.2.12. So Muni. Munayaha. Munayaha. Shraddhadhanaha. Munayaha. Shrutagruhitaya. Acha acha. You come like this. Prabhu, pen, ink. Is there a... Shrutagruhitaya. Munayaha. Shraddhadhanaha. 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 What he will do? Bhaktya. So, okay. Bhaktya pashyanti atmani chatmanu. So, now see the commentary on this. Bhaktya tatkatha ruchereva paravastha rupaya prema lakshanaya. In this sloka, what is said? This Muni is seeing tattvam. Is seeing the tattvam. By what he is seeing? By the bhakti. Bhaktya means by bhakti he is seeing. By bhakti. What is this bhakti here? Here the bhakti means? He said bhakti is prema. Which is coming from where? Which is coming from tat katha ruchehe eva. Bhaktya means tat katha ruchehe eva paravastha rupaya. That means initially what? Katha ruchi. Initially katha ruchi, basic katha ruchi is there. And its extremeness of this also bhakti. Katha ruchi is also bhakti or not? Is bhakti. So this is basic katharuchi, and the extremity of this is what? That is prema. That you should take here bhakti means. And by that bhakti he is seeing tattvam. But just here bhakti means in this sloka, not katharuchi. Because just see basic katharuchi, can anyone see the param, that means Lord in their heart? They cannot see. That means here what is the condition is given? He is seeing the Lord in his heart. Means that bhakti is definitely extreme, prema bhakti. Which is the final stage of basic thing. That is katharuchi. Basic katharuchi. Okay. Now, prema lakshaya. Tat purvameva uktam tattvam. Atmani means Shuddhe Chetasi. What they see? They see in their heart Atmanam means what you should take here. He see in his heart Tattvam, which is said previously in this loka. Vadanti Tat Tattva Vidas Tattvam. That Tattvam only he sees in his heart. So through this Bhakti, which is Prema, which is extreme stage of, final stage of this Katharuchi. Now, what about other words? Where he sees this? Where he sees this tattvam? In the heart. Atmani means in the heart. Suddha chetasi, in the pure heart. So now, next, ज्ञान मात्रस्य का वार्ता साक्षादपि कुर्वन्ति इत्यर्थः. So means what? Here, this person is not simply knowing this tattvam. No, what he is doing by this bhakti, he is seeing directly. Seeing sakshat kriyate, yes, is directly seeing by this bhakti, not simply knowing, but he is directly seeing. Kidrusham tat atmanam, that means he is seeing tattvam. What kind of tattvam? Kidrusham tat, what kind of tattvam? That is atmanam swarupakya jivakya maya shaktinam ashrayam. He is seeing what in his heart? This is tattvam. In the heart he is seeing through the bhakti. So what is this? This is swarupakya. It is the sum total of swarupa. Swarupa shakti plus jiva shakti and maya shakti. Maya Shakti, shelter. Shelter of this. Of is not necessary. If you put something in the parenthesis and write shelter, that means what? Shelter of. Yes. So that is that tattvam he is seeing in the heart. By what? Jnana vairagya yuktaya. That means swatma jabhyam tabhyam sevitaya. So jnana vairagya yuktaya means this bhakti when he does, which is nothing but the prema. Bhakti means here prema. So this bhakti is also having the two children. Hana? If you do bhakti, it is having the two children. One is jnana and vairagya. That means it is assisted by her two children. One is jnana and another is vairagya.
Is atmanam. Pasyanti atmani atmanam cha. So here written Swarup Shakti, Jeev Shakti, Maya Shakti. So is he seeing shelter of Swarup Shakti, Maya Shakti, Jeev Shakti? That means Lord,
yes.
Or Lord along with Swarup Shakti, Jeev Shakti and Maya Shakti, just like Vyasdevsa, Mayam Chatuda Pasrem. So like that, or similar, simply only seeing the Lord. But if Lord is seeing, why is written Swarup Shelter? That means he's seeing Shakti also, is it?
Yes. No. So, if, good question, bro. So, if that Upasaka, this person, Muni, if he is not seeing the Shaktis and seeing the only Lord, means that is Brahman. That is Brahman. Understand? So, if you see the Lord without his Shaktis, means you are seeing him as Brahman. But we are saying, we are seeing him as Ashraya of all these Shaktis, means Purna Chandraha, like Bhagavan. That's the Bhagavan. Ekdam like that. Yes. Mike.
That Upasaka, what is seeing, realizing in Atmani, means in heart. The Lord is saying, Maya Shakti is saying, Swarup Shakti is saying, but here Jiva Shakti is written. Jiva Shakti means Jiva himself or all Jiva like that. What is Jiva?
Yeah, he is seeing Jiva Shakti is also.
In creation.
He is the shelter of that.
Whatever Jiva there.
Yes.
Can you please clarify?
No. Jiva Shakti means what? He is seeing everything is connected to him. Okay, anyway. So now come to this. What is happening? Muni, by bhakti means prema, which is coming from the Katharuchi, by that seeing the tattvam in his heart, that tattvam is the shelter of Swarupa Shakti, Jeeva Shakti and Maya Shakti. Okay, this connection is okay. Now, what is the next is sir? And this bhakti is assisted by Jnana and Vairagya. Jnana Vairagya Yuktaya Swatmajabhyam Tabhyam Tata Eva Cha Te Munayaha Pratak Cha Vishishtam Cha Svechaya Pashyanti Ityayat. So here Atayeva cha te munayaha pratakcha vishishtam sa svechaya pashyanti ityayat. So, she is, bhakti is served by jnana and vairagya. Means, they are, these two, jnana is servant of the bhakti means, what you should understand, this yogi or muni, sorry, this muni, if he wants, he can see by the jnana without seeing the shaktis as Brahman, or otherwise he can see by bhakti complete that he is having the independence. Here what he said, jnana vairagya yuktaya bhaktya, he said. This statement, what it is establishing? That Muni is having the free will of seeing this tattvam either bhakti directly or so, which is served by the jnana means, bhakti is served by the jnana means, they can sometimes see that same tattvam as, that means as Brahman by the jnana. Okay, because jnana vairagya yuktaya is said, because these two are, what we are saying, those are the independent. Means what, devotees, if they want, they can see Krishna as Krishna, and if they want, they can also see Brahman. That is, if they want. Okay. Ata eva te munayaha pratakcha vishishtam sa svechaya pashyanti. They have independence. The what? Pratak means kevala jnanam. Pratak means kevala jnanam. That means Brahman. Or vishishtam means along with the shaktis. Vishishtam means along with the shaktis. That means now, if you want to see what, how to write this, this muni, by this jnana and vairagya, so he may see tattvam as Brahman. That means without shaktis, or as Bhagavan full. That is independence only. Because these two are not dominating bhakti. They are assisting the bhakti. So that's why by using that jnana, he may see that as by his own free will, he may see as Brahman, or otherwise by that bhakti, he can see as Bhagavan. Okay. Next. Tadevam srata grihitaya munayaha sraddhadhana. This is clear. Now come to him. That from this what philosophy is established? Bhakti is the master and it is served by her own two children. What is Jnana and Vairagya? And this Muni is a, that means devotee. And this devotee can see the tattvam by his own free will, either as Brahman or Bhagavan, in his heart. And by this bhakti, he is seeing. That means he is directly experiencing. It's not that he is knowing, but he is directly seeing. That means direct sakshatkara, direct realization is happening. That means bhakti can give the direct realization. Okay. This is the point. Now we will discuss about this. This person is what? This person is this three. How? That means he is having the bhakti. How he is having this bhakti? That is the main question, main topic for us. By bhakti, he is seeing everything and this is also okay. But our main interest is what? How he is getting the bhakti, this bhakti. How he is getting this bhakti. So this bhakti is nothing but the prema, which is coming from the katha ruchi. But how it is coming here? Shruta grihitaya munayaha shraddha dhanaha. These three visheshanas are very important. Till now, before this sloka, before to this, how one is getting the katha ruchi? How? How? Before to that also we have seen devotee is getting the, that means upasaka is getting the katha ruchi. How he got? By following the, by doing the dharma. No, by doing the dharma for the satisfaction of Hari, then it is giving the katha ruchi, and then one will be doing the, that means by that katha ruchi, he will be doing the sravanam kirtanam. Yes? But here also this upasaka is getting the bhakti, that is coming from the katha ruchi. How this bhakti, this katha ruchi is coming? Shruta gruhitaya munayaha shraddhadhanaha. Shruta gruhitaya, first we should see what it means, shruta gruhitaya. No question, right? No. Let me complete this. So shruta grihitaya means tadevam shruta grihitaya munayah shraddhadanah iti padatrayena tasyah eva bhakteh daurlabhyam darshitam. So here it is not said that this person is getting the bhakti just by following his dharma, is not said. Shruta grihitaya is said. That means shruta grihisa means, you should understand, shruta grihitaya means, this is one, you keep 1, 2, and 3. PPT, you write everything, capture it, this diagram. Full attention, we need. Shruta grihitaya means, Sadguroho Sakshat, Sadguru. Sadguroho Sakshat, Vedantadhyakala Shastrardha Vichara Sravana Dwara. Online students, are you able to follow the text? Yes? Raise the hand, yes. Yes. I am not able to see your... Yeah, screen, that's okay. Shruta grihitaya means Sadguru. Sadguroha Sakshat Vedantadhyakala Shastra. Shruta means hearing the Vedas. Hearing the, so this person is coming here. You see, he came here. He is going to where here now? He is going to Guru. Not ordinary Guru. Sadguru. Bonafide spiritual master. He is going to the bonafide spiritual master, and what he is doing, this person, he is hearing the all the Vedas, not just Vedas, he is hearing the meanings of Vedanta, mane akila shastrartha vichara shravana dwara. That means he is hearing, this person is hearing. This person is hearing what? The meanings of the his deliberations of meanings of all the shastras, all the Vedanta shastras. That means this person is hearing the meanings of all the Vedanta shastras. Okay. First of all, that means Upanishads, all the Brahmanas, Aranyakas, Karmakanda, everything. So he is here, he will be hearing, not just hearing like that mantras he is not hearing. He is hearing the meaning. And Shastrartha Vicharaha, the meanings of all those Shastras. Then, after that what? And if that is properly done, let us assume that it is properly done. Then what will happen? Yadi avashyaka parama kartavyatvena jnayate. So next sa bhaktihi, that means by hearing, so he understood, that means by hearing all the shastras, and the meanings. So he understood that bhakti should be done. Let us assume if we come to this conclusion, it's not guarantee. Okay? If we come to the conclusion that bhakti should be done. Huh? It's not guaranteed because he's hearing the shastras, he's sometimes maybe there is misunderstanding by his own or some other reasons. But he is hearing all the meanings of the shastras, Upanishads, Sankhya Shastra, Mimamsa, Nyaya, Vedanta, all Purva Mimamsa, Uttar Mimamsa, Yoga Sutras, and also Brahmana, Saranyakas, Karmakanda, everything he is hearing and finding the meanings. And finally, so Edi. Suppose by doing that, if we come to conclusion that bhakti should be done, then after that, what he should do next? Next, mananam he should do. Muni said, na? Sota Goswami, what he is saying? This person is Muni. That means next step is mananam. Mananam means, what is example for mananam? Once upon a time, we heard in the second canto, second chapter. What we heard? I know. Brahma Bhagavan Brahma Karsnena Triranviksha Manishaya Tadadyavasyat Kutastho Ratiratmanyato Bhavet. What is this meaning? I know. If anyone tell, then that is surprising. And if they do. Puneet Babu? Babu knows. So what Brahmaji did on that day? Brahmaji, what he did on that day? So Sukadeva Goswami was explaining. So bhakti is the ultimate. After explaining of what? After explaining the Krama Mukti and the Sadhya Mukti. Sadhya Mukti and Krama Mukti finally. So what he is saying in that second chapter? Second chapter, what is the content? Everything is cancelled. That's why Prabhupada always says, any word, any term comes, better no need to confuse them. Translate that into bhakti so that it is easy. So handling the students is very easy. So instead of confusing them, this Nishkama Karma Yoga is different, and the Sankhya Yoga is different, Jnana Yoga is different. Better translate everything into one, and then everyone will easily do the bhakti.
Nahi ato annashya pantha.
Huh.
So that is it. Brahma's conclusion came. Three anviksha, three times by contemplating.
Yeah.
Manishya.
So that chapter, if you see in that chapter, so he is starting with the sadhaka, how he should live. That means
1.2.33.
Yeah. So then after that, explaining about the sadhaka and what things came in that chapter? In that first. So yeah, anyway, let's leave it. Okay. Now, this Brahmaji. So now we are coming to the stage of manano. So somehow this person, after hearing from his guru, he came to know that yes, bhakti should be done. For suppose somehow or good luck. So after hearing all these shastras, he came to know bhakti should be done. It's not that a guarantee that after hearing all the shastras of the meanings of all the shastras, it is not necessary that he should come, but first of all, he came to that bhakti should be done. Then he should do mananam like what? Like Brahmaji. Brahmaji, how he did mananam? One time what he did, he took this hoe, one day he sat and he was thinking, so I'm doing every day studying these Vedas and doing the secondary creation. So what is the final conclusion of this? And like this, he was contemplating. Mananam means is a contemplation of and his own knowledge. So then let me check today. I will see what is the meaning of this, final meaning of this Vedas. So first time he saw from the starting to ending, Brahma Karsnena. What he said here, Karsnena means completely. Three Ranviksha Manisha. Manishaya means Brahmaji's intelligence is super duper intelligence. In this whole creation, the best intelligent person is who is that? Brahmaji only. In this material creation. Because his body is completely his intelligence. So with that intelligence, he contemplated on these Vedas. All the Vedas. First time he thought karma can be the conclusion of these Vedas. Thinking, keeping that idea into account. So instead of, that means opposite to bhakti, something he is considering and that may be conclusion. So with that idea, he checked the total Vedas. Then karma is not the conclusion, he found. Then after that, okay, jnana might be the conclusion. So with that view, he checked once again all the Vedas. Jnana is also not the conclusion. Then after that, finally, so maybe bhakti can be the conclusion of all the Vedas. So with that view, he saw. Then, yes, bhakti is the conclusion. That means, what is that? Kutastha rati ratman ato bhavet. That means, that is the conclusion of Vedas. What is the conclusion of the Vedas according to the Brahmaji? That is the conclusion which gives the rati in the Krishna. So that means bhakti. So that means mananam means what happens? It is removing the all the viparita bhavanas, which are against to the main one. Those all removed in the stage of mananam. Like in here, what happened? Karma and jnana, which are the viparita bhavanas to the bhakti, those removed or not? That is the stage of the mananam. Okay. Contemplation. Mananam he did. Then after that also, after doing the mananam, so Bhagavan Brahma Karsnena Tri Ranviksha Manishaya Tadadyavasyat Kutastho Rati Ratman Yato Bhavet Itivat Yadi Viparita Bhavana Tyajakau Manana Yogyata Manana Binivesho Syatam. So that means viparita bhavanas are finished in the stage of this hearing is done, step one, and next second step, mananam, that means contemplation. Mananam is done, then after that, viparita bhavanas are finished, then his mind is what? Abhinivesho. Then he got the yogyata. Yogyata. Yogyata of what? Yogyata. Manana yogyata, manana abhinivesho. So that means manana yogyata, manana abhinivesho means he is able to understand the subject matter deeply. Abhinivesho means he entered, his mind is entered into the real subject matter. Means finally he came to the conclusion that, properly he came to conclusion that, yes, bhakti is the conclusion. So then after that, what will happen? Then he will get tata sraddha dhanaihi. That means once after getting the all viparita bhavanas are gone, now finally his bhakti is firm. That means he fully believing. Yes. Then that is known as sraddha. Yes. Sraddha dhanaihi. By sravanam and by the mananam, he is getting the sraddha. By this sraddha, what he, once after having the sraddha, what he will do? He will be getting the katha ruchi. And that means he will be doing the then shravanam. That means this shravanam is what? Shravanam of the past tense, holy name. Nama rupa guna leela shravanam. Yes or no? Getting or not? So by this sraddha, then what he will do? Sraddha after he getting, what he will do? He will be doing the upasana. Yes or no? After getting the sraddha, you will do the, you will worshipping that object, whatever you have the final conclusion. That means what? You got to, you come to know the hearing about that object and also glorifying that object and also remembering that object and paying obeisance to that object, you will keep on doing that. Then by that, you will be seeing that in the heart. That's all process is already explained. So, what is happening? The same thing is also explained. This shravanam, mananam, and sraddhadana means upasana. Sraddha getting means what? Upasana. You'll be doing the upasana. So that's why you can take this step as upasana. So this is also is said, this kind of process is also said in the Vedas, in the Upanishads. What is that? Atma vare drashtavyaha srotavyaha mantavyaha nididhyasitavyascha. Atma vare srotavyaha mantavyaha nididhyasitavyascha. Nididhyasan means upasana. Is a part of the upasana. So then what? Drashtavya, then he will see. Okay? This is the, so Nididhyasana means Darshan Shakshatkaram. Here, what? In this process, how Katharuchi came? He went to Guru and he heard all the Shastras, meanings of all the Shastras. Then after that, he did the Mananam. Then he came to the conclusion. Then, so he got the Ruchi, Katharuchi, and then he worshipped. Then he got the finally Darshan of the Tattva. This process, second process, this. How this bhakti is coming? This is the second. One is by doing the dharma for the satisfaction of Hari. This is one and this is two. 1.2.12 is explaining about the second way of getting bhakti. And remaining slokas are explained the first way.
Question.
Okay. Sacha evam durlabha bhakti aritoshane prayukta swabhagi dharmadapi labhyate. So?
Question.
So now, we'll stop here and we'll take questions.
Either.
Okay. Wait. Questions? Yes.
Cool. You said both the processes look same. One is at advanced state and is another is at initial state.
What?
Both the process are.
Who are both?
You said that process and this process are different.
Yes.
But both are same. Both are about the hearing about Krishna Katha and both are about hearing Krishna Katha.
Why both are hearing about Krishna Katha? You are also, PPT should read nicely, huh?
Yes.
So that's why I should explain to you once again. In this, what is happening? Second, in this 1.2.12, he is doing the, studying the all the Shastras from the Guru. And then after that, understanding. First, suppose he somehow came to the conclusion that bhakti should be done. Then after that, he also doing the mananam, so to remove all the opposite feelings of that. And then after that, finally, he is getting the Shraddha. On that, then he will be doing the Upasana. That means he is doing the actual Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasavanam. Okay. And this, that one is what? He is doing the Dharma. No Sravanam Givanam, nothing. What he is doing? His Dharma is doing the his occupational duties for the satisfaction of Hari. And then he got the Katharuchi. Then after that, he will be doing the Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasavanam. What is the problem? Simple thing. Is there any difficulty? Yes, you have difficulty? Okay.
You said, yes, Sansai is there. Two process. First, you told with the dharma, by doing dharma satisfaction, one gets Katharuchi. Then after that, you Srut Grihiteya, you explained. And that Srut Grihiteya, that Ruchi gets like that, when approaching, Srut Grihitya means approaching to bona fide Guru. When he develops that
Sadguru.
Is, Sadguru.
Yes.
That, so then he develops Prema. That is, that Katharuchi is, that Bhakti is Prema, not like beginning Bhakti. Is it clear? Okay, no?
No, I'm not clear.
They explained there. Then Pasyanti Atmani Chatmanam Srut Grihitya Munya Sradhana Munya. So that Bhakti arises, that out of Prema, not like out of Prema is seeing.
Yes.
So why? Because Srut Grihitya means he approached the bona fide Guru.
No. That is not. That is due to the bhakti he is seeing.
Due to the bhakti.
But that Grihitya means whole explanation. Doob gaya aapka.
No, no. Oh. But how are you reaching this point? Munya Sraddhana, but that is
With that process.
Then he reaching that stage.
Yes.
That means he approach process is like approaching the bona fide guru and hearing.
Yes.
Then develops bhakti, that prema. Because the prema is seeing the Lord, not like the so process sut grihitya, gyan vairagyuktya. That is clear.
Yes.
Okay. And for us, our cases, as said, is the Munyaha person approaches the
our cases means ISKCON devotees.
Yeah, I'm asking.
ISKCON devotees case I will explain later. Yeah. It will come. It will come. I will explain ours case also. ISKCON devotees case will be the next. Okay, Sri Chand Prabhu.
Prabhu, by that prema, we can see either as Brahman or Paramatma or Bhagavan, that is independent will.
Yes.
But if he contemplated properly, that opposing elements are removed, jnana, karma, etc. So he will see Bhagavan. Why one will go to Brahman or Paramatma?
Come again, Prabhu. Sorry.
He can, by his free will, he can see Brahman or Paramatma or Bhagavan. The tattva is Brahman or Paramatma or Bhagavan in the prema stage.
Yes.
But if he is doing this process, Srutagrihitaya, and contemplated and firmly, his bhakti became firm and he is doing Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, all that, then he should see Bhagavan, no? That conclusion he should reach, no? So Brahman and...
Definitely he will be reaching to the Bhagavan only, but free will, that's why we are saying free will. There is no guarantee, that means he is having full free will because he is supported by the, his bhakti supported by the Jnana and Vairagya. So even in the other places also we know, devotees have the that facility of seeing the Bhagavan if they want as Brahman also. There is no need to do any other special process to see Brahman for the case of devotees. By his, their pure devotional service, if they want, they can see so Lord also as Brahman, but they don't want.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't want. But they have that kind of facility. That is the point actually here, that they are given with that, but they don't want. Switch.
Yes, Prabhu.
Yeah. So next. Online. No questions? Oh, I expected more questions. Arjun Saka Prabhu? No questions? No. Mother? Radha Rohini Mataji? Okay. Then if there are no questions, you have a question? Okay. 1 minute is there.
Yes. Yeah. So, Prabhu, there are two processes. In one process, one person is performing his occupational duties for Hari Toshna, and he developed taste for hearing.
Yes.
And the second process, he goes to the Guru, Sadguru, and he hears Krishna Katha, and develops then Mananam, then Nididhyasam.
Yes.
After that is Bhakti.
The Shravanam.
Shravanam,
Satagrihita means Shravanam of all the Vedic literatures. Then Mananam, Vipradvayanam done. Then he got the Shraddha. That means he started Upasana. Upasana means, that means whatever conclusion he got from that, that means Krishna is the Supreme Personality, he got that kind of conclusion he got. Then what he will do? Upasana means Nama, Rupa, Guna, Leela, Shravanam of Krishna.
Okay.
Then he will do that.
Then he develop Prem.
Yes.
Prem. Then the first process where he was performing the occupational duty, then later he is coming to the same, the second process where he will do Krishna Katha and do worship.
He will get the develop Krishna Katha and then also he also hearing and doing and bhakti only will do. Okay. So, but what are the different ways we are seeing?
Okay.
Okay. How to come to the bhakti we are seeing by these two things. Okay. We will also discuss tomorrow. ISKCON devotee's case.
One more question, bro. One more question.
What is that?
How 7B connection? We were discussing about tattva. And we discussed this tattvas and three different definitions. Then 7B came. And this 7B, this shloka came. What was the connection?
Connection is nothing but... So, dharma only is what is explained in the previous 8 and 9. What is that? 9 and 10 actually. 9 and 10. And 11 is vadanti tattva vidastattvam. So, that is the 11. Okay. 11 is telling about the what is tattvam. And after that, so till the 11, till the 10, we are seeing that dharma, which is done for the satisfaction of Hari. secondary result is knowledge. That also we saw in two places. Vasudeva Bhagat Bhakti Prayat, there also you saw. And here also, ultimately second result is a Tattva Jignasa. From that also you understood. So then in that way, that chapter is side. And then after that, so this Tattvam, which can be manifesting in the three ways, Brahma, Paramatma, Bhagavan, that can be realized by the Munis like this. This is another process we are seeing. Okay. Now we'll make a question on this. Okay. What are the two different processes of getting the bhakti? Explain elaborately. 15 marks. Yes, yesterday, day before yesterday, 2 days, 3 classes. If you have any doubt, you can write the answer and send to us. We can check it and we'll tell whether it is right or wrong. And also, I request all of you to contribute in the PPT. So, whoever committed, where is Namaruchi Prabhu? Namaruchi is absent today. Namaruchi lost the Bhakti Sandarbha Ruchi. Okay. Srila Prabhupada ki.